wanted to talk to you about yesterday.
Okay, please, let's do it. Sit down. Let's talk. I want you to know that you can trust me. Whatever you want to know.
Well, on the way over here, I replayed all that you said yesterday. I heard all that you said, but I was very angry. Even if it was for my own protection.
Look, I was not going to drag you into a war between Phallon and Victor. I love you too much for that. Now, what if something would have happened to you? Then what?
I could have done something, anything. Maybe Ronnie will still be alive.
Well, if I can go back and do it all over again, I would. Especially knowing that it hurt you like this. But nothing I can do now. Could go back and do it again, I would, especially knowing that it hurt you like this. But I can't. Be mad at me, but don't let it just be the end of us.
A part of me hears you, but a part of me is still very angry. We was at a place of peace, and now this. What would you do if you was me?
You have every right to be mad, upset, all of that. What I did was wrong. But if it was me, I mean, I would find it in my heart to forgive you. It may not be today or tomorrow, but I would be willing to wait. I mean, look, you just can't let the words of some psychopath destroy us.
Well, that psychopath was telling the truth this time. And nobody should blame me if I was gone forever.
But that would be a coward's way out.
Excuse me, you were the one in the wrong.
Running away never solves anything, though. We just need to put everything on the table because we can't go on like this.
So what do we do now? How do we get back on track?
First, by realizing that we love each other and we are willing to be together. Because there's no man that's gonna love you like I love you.
Oh, are you sure about that?
Damn sure. Look, we've been through hell and back, and I would do it all over again if it means that you're gonna be by my side.
Of course.
You still love me, right?
Yes, I do. But if there's anything you need to tell me about Ronnie or anything, now is the time to tell me.
Nah, I swear on my life, there is nothing else.
Deep down, I know you were only trying to protect me. I just wish you would have did it a different way.
Okay. Well, I was going to just come over your house and give you this back.
And you just knew I was going to take it back, huh?
It was a risk I was willing to take. I mean, it belongs to you. So, can I put it back on?
Of course you can.
I missed you so much.
I missed you too.
It was one night too long.
It's only been one night though.
Too long.
She's really my fucking daughter. My God. God, why have you forsaken me? Fucking evil child. Ever since I got the East End. First Clint.
But I don't want you to leave.
Baby, I gotta take care of this business. I don't want to leave either. You know, I don't like being gone for you for so long.
You're always in Easton now. You used to go like, every other month, and now you're there like every weekend.
Baby, when you take care of your business takes care of you. Right?
You can take care of your wife. You're going to come home and somebody else going to be up there.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
I'm not laughing.
I don't take care of my wife. I don't take care of my wife. Somewhat. Girl, what are you trying to say, girl? Somewhat.
I'm talking about other departments.
Baby.
What?
Come on, don't act like that.
I just miss you.
All right, so what you doing this weekend?
I'm not doing anything. If you're going to be home, I'll stay home.
I'll stay home, but you got to make a deal.
What's the deal?
No emails, no working from your computer, no stressing over your dad.
Okay. So you're going to stay home?
I'll stay home.
I'll do it next weekend, too.
Okay. Next weekend, I have to go to Easton.
See?
But hey, we're not going to look past what's going on.
I should have to make an appointment with my husband.
We're not. Mrs. Phallon Davenport, are you telling me you shouldn't have to make an appointment with your husband?
That's what I'm
as
saying.
As many times I had to make appointments with my wife.
Well, I miss you.
I miss you too. But look.
What?
Matter of fact, I'm going to set some stuff up now. We're going to chill out, enjoy each other this weekend. And that's going to be that.
Okay.
All mine, all weekend.
No, all mine all weekend.
Okay.
All right. Pepper. I love you.
I love you too.
Get up!
I'll be right back.
Hey, Winston. I need you to go to Easton. No, not this weekend, next weekend. Just keep an eye on Clint. Okay? All right, I'll text you with the rest of the details. All right, bye.
Then Ashton. Then Clayton. Now Raven. Winston. Winston. Winston, Winston.
I'm ready, Winston. Just tell me who the woman is that Clint's been sleeping with.
Phallon, that's the thing. It's a little bit more complicated than just that woman.
Complicated? What is it? Multiple women? We have children? Is he raping somebody? What is he into? Porn? Tell me what's going on with him. Why are you grabbing my hand?
Phallon, I don't really know how to say this. I'll just say it. Clint is sleeping with a man.
A what?
A man.
No. A man. Hold up. Okay, a male, a boy. Like you, a man.
A man.
Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Are you sure?
I know it sounds like...
Hold up, a man.
I saw it myself. He was with them long-haired fella.
What's...
Ashton Banks.
Wait, this is a lot. This is a lot. It's a lot. Just... Let me process this. My husband is sleeping with a man.
Yep, that piece of shit husband is not cheating on you with a woman, but a man.
What's his name? What's his name?
His name is Ashton Banks. He owns a clothing company, Banks Designs. I've done a little research and there's a little bit more.
What else could there be? They don't have children.
Prepare yourself a little bit for this. I know you, and I need you to be calm. Clint is funding Ashton's clothing line.
That's not true, because Clint ain't got no money. He ain't funding nothing with no money. You gotta have to dig deeper, boo. He can't be.
Phallon, he's using your money to fund.
He's using who money?
Yours.
Oh, hell no. How long has this been going on?
Some time. A little bit. I don't know exactly, but it's been a bit extensive. They seem very
close. Take me to him. Take me to Ashton Banks.
Take you to him.
If he has a clothing company and it's being funded by me, that means I own it. It's my money.
Phallon, when have we ever rushed like a bull into something? We are strategic people. We are not. No, listen.
This man is cheating on me with a man. As in, no offense, but
listen,
a man.
This is what's going to happen.
That shit is nasty.
Listen. I always protect you, correct? Always. I have a plan. Trust me, I have a plan. But it does not require us confronting either Clint or Ashton at this point. You keep your calm and follow my instructions. As long as you follow me all the way through, I promise you everything's going to turn out exactly how we wanted to. I know it's not easy to take in.
My fucking man.
I know.
Okay. Gotta do what we gotta do.
Oh my fucking God, why do you feel like that?
Shut up, feel like what?
You know what I mean, like during sex. Why does our sex feel like that? That's crazy.
Shut up.
I'm serious. You got me in here acting all crazy, doing shit I don't know what to do. Like, this is, it's too much.
Oh, so you don't normally do this kind of stuff, huh?
No, not all this layup and everything.
Well, you better get used to it because you're going to start doing a lot more of it. Right?
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, if you keep doing that, like... Of course. You remember what we were talking about last month?
About what?
Remember when I asked you, like, where you saw yourself at in 5 years, and you said...
I want my own business. You know that. Mm-hmm.
I was thinking about it, you know. And I believe in you, Ashton.
I know, you told me you believe me. I know that.
No, I really do. And if, like, owning your own business and starting your own fashion line is your dream, and that's where you see yourself, I want to help. You know, I want to be there for you, you know, and I just want to make sure that you'll be okay, you know, and taken care of, so to speak. So, I did something.
You did what?
Well, did you? First, I did a little research, you know. I know I have a friend or two that's, like, in fashion.
Okay.
I know people.
Okay.
And, fashion is in.
Boy, fashion is always in.
Whoa. I decided to make a decision. So, this is your startup money for your business.
startup money for my fashion business?
Yeah.
What?
Surprise.
No, this is not a surprise. This...
not.
You know, I can't... Look, this is a lot of money, I'm pretty sure, and...
it's my money. You don't have to worry about nothing. And of course, I'm gonna be a silent partner. Like, if you make money, I'm making money.
It's just a lot of responsibility and...
is this not what you want to do? Is this not what you want to do?
Of course.
How long have you been thinking about this?
Clint, you know that's all my life.
You got mad designs. I saw your book. I got you. I'm gonna make sure you okay. And if you okay, I'm okay. Right?
All right.
Trust me. Emails, you know. Work.
I guess.
How was the walk?
It was refreshing. But I just came back in to thank you for last night.
I should thank you for last night.
Thank you for all of last night. And with that said, I got to thinking about everything. And it was just one thing that didn't settle with me.
What?
Clint, about this whole marriage thing. It's like, I know you're not happy, and if you really believe in what we talked about last night, and us starting a future and all that stuff, and doing business together.
Very much. Ashton, I'm not with just some around the way, girl. You know that. My wife is very powerful and very, very rich. And I just can't up and divorce her so quickly. And you're right, I'm not happy. We haven't been happy for a long time, but marriage is not always about like being happy. It's about what works. You understand? Look, let me work that in. I'll do what I can. But I got you.
You got me in what way?
What'd I tell you? Who got you? Who's gonna take care of you? Who's gonna make sure you're okay? I got you, boy. I didn't just do what I did just to showboat. I believe in you. I do.
Okay. Okay. I'm gonna hold you to that.
Hold me to that. Promise. Round four.
Yeah.
Is everything okay? Who? Who's dead? What? You killed him? And Vicky, what happened after I left?
Jesus, sit down.
Fucking dream.
Sit down! Sit down, Jesus. He made your life a living fucking hell. He made your life a living fucking hell.
Vicky, he was my dad.
Yeah, but he's fucking gone now, okay? He's gone. You're not gonna mourn.
What the hell is gonna happen now?
Right now?
Me? Why me? And Vicky, I always hated Victor's everything he's fucking represented. I fucking hate it. Why the fuck do I want to be on the mob? Yes, but
Jesus, I want you in full control.
Funny. Yeah. So, Brandon, I know you don't want to hear his name again, but...
Don't say his name. Don't say his name.
Nobody will ever fuck
I don't want to be.
Shut the fuck up and man up. It's your fucking legacy now. You handle it as a DeLuca family should. Nobody's gonna fuck with you. You fucking understand? You're gonna take this fucking business. And you're gonna follow by my example. You feel me? Let your father bleed like the snake he was. He's gone. This is what you wanted.
Good riddance.
Okay, well, he shall remain nameless. Feels very awful about what happened. You can't let the damn poor mess get in between your friendship.
He withheld information as well. He's just as guilty as the rest of them.
He was only trying to help. Our friendship cannot be breaking up. We like Destiny's Child, Charlie's Angels, 3LW. We tied together forever.
I want out the group.
Okay, well, be that way, Beyonce. I'm just trying to help.
You can help by changing the subject.
Fine. How's things with Jabril? I heard about his secret. The nerve of him to withhold information from us.
How did you find out? Oh, I forgot. Motor mouth.
Yeah, he called me right after you went to go see him. I gagged so hard, I couldn't even finish my client's hair.
I was so mad at Jabril. To find out about Ronnie from Victor, of all people. I mean, after I calmed down, I kinda understood why Jabril kept it from me, but that don't make it right.
It doesn't. Victor needs his ass kicked, dragged, ragtag, dragged, thrown stones at him, but we'll just leave you and Jabril.
We good. I forgave him. Me and Jabril have been through so much and I love him so much. Mm-hmm. I just can't let go of what we've been building.
Yeah, y'all have been building a lot, but I hope this is the last of the secrets. Now we can get back to planning this fabulous wedding. Extravaganza. It should be outside. No, I don't like rain. Rain will make my hair look terrible. It should be inside. The theme should be Paris in the springtime. It should be Eiffel Towers, clouds, white roses everywhere. We need live models as angels, harps, pianos. Right. What is wrong with you?
I'm fine.
Clearly something is up. I'm talking about your wedding and you pay me no mind. I know you BFF. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
All I said was weddings, flowers, and secret. Please don't tell me nothing else happened. Please.
Yes. And you have to promise me you won't ever say anything.
I promise I won't say anything. What is it this
time? Kiko, I'm serious. I didn't want to tell you, but I need to get this off my chest.
I'm your best friend. We tell each other everything. Okay, I promise. What is it?
The other day, Rob came over to visit.
Rob, oh shit, this cannot be good.
Kiko, listen.
Okay, go ahead. My lips are sealed. Won't say nothing.
He came over. We started talking about our relationships. We got drunk. And we had sex.
I'm hearing you clearly. Let me move my weave. Did I hear you right? Brandon, please tell me you're right.
No. I woke up, he was next to me. He promised he won't ever say anything. Please don't judge me.
I'm not judging you. I will never judge you, best friend. But damn, Rob. Rob, out of all people, I bet he's feeling himself. So black on top of black.
No, he regretted it too.
Please, that's bullshit. He loved every minute of it. He been waiting for years to fuck you.
How you know he fucked me? And besides, that's never, ever, 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 ever happened again. It's not ever happening again. He's with Dirk. I'm engaged to Jabril. We could just go on about our normal lives.
Ain't nothing normal in Easter. You better hope he take this to his grave. Better yet, how about I run him over? Then he can go to his grave early. I'm your best friend. I'll do that for you.
Boom! He said he is, and I for damn sure am taking it to mine.
Okay, all this gossip making me hungry, thirsty, and I need some great goose. Let's go out to eat and get some a drink. You ain't getting no drinks. You getting on your Shirley Temple, or apple cider, or some eggnog, or tea, for a little lemon. Nah, sweetened.
Okay, Kiko, we have to promise me you won't ever say nothing. This cannot leave this room.
I promise. I'm forgetting about it already. I'm writing it down and I'm tanning up, ripping it. I forgot about it.
Okay.
So let's go out to eat. But wait, I can't deal with this anymore. I looked into it, and guess what I found out?
What you find?
I can't.
Come on.
I researched it, and guess what I found out?
What you find?
That I can't. Let's go get some meat.
Let's go get some meat.
I need a drink or two. Make sure you get your shirty temple. Yeah, because you're not drinking at all. This shit right here? I can't. All right,
come on. Yeah. Such good news to tell you.
Good news. Do you know how you sound right now?
Yeah, but you want to hear this, trust me.
Do you know what JJ is?
No, it's better than that.
What could be better than that?
Victor is dead.
What?
I'm serious, he's fucking dead. The asshole's gone. Did you know what this means?
What do you mean Victor's dead?
I mean, he's fucking dead. Vicky told me herself. But she did it herself.
What are you saying? I don't believe you. He's dead.
Are you happy?
How could I be happy? This is way too convenient. You mean to tell me that now that the secret's out about JJ, conveniently Victor's dead? It doesn't make any sense.
Vicky wouldn't lie to us.
How do you know? Did she show you the body?
What is with all the questions? You should be so fucking happy right now.
Because even if what you're saying is true, Victor's death solves nothing. Ronnie's dead. Eve is in a fucking nut house somewhere. And we still can't find JJ. How the fuck do you expect me to be happy about that?
We can find JJ together. I can actually ask Aunt Vicky to help us.
I don't want her or anybody in your family nowhere near JJ.
Vicky's not gonna hurt him. I can ask her for money and the resources to find him. But her guys can help us out.
If you think for a second I'm going to accept that blood money, you don't know me at all.
I don't get it. This whole time you've been telling me to take more responsibility and more charge. And I'm doing that, and you still have a problem with it.
Not at the expense of flexing your last name. Do you hear yourself? You're standing like some fucking mafioso with all the answers. And what about the FBI agent?
Where is it?
Phallon, my brother's not here, and from what I heard, he doesn't want to see you.
Oh, really?
Really.
First you bring your brother into my life and he makes me like a goddamn fool, and then he turns around and has sex with Ray. And now he doesn't want to see me? Really?
Yeah, he told me that you came by here looking for me, I guess because you needed help solving your problem with Jabril's love child. You know, the one that you forgot to mention to me.
I don't want to talk about that anymore. And besides, I came here to talk to you about something else. Raven is my daughter. I had a DNA test and it's confirmed.
Wow. So, how do you feel about that?
Winston, I don't know how to feel. For so many years, I thought if and when I was to find out who my child was and we were to be reunited, I would know it instantly. There would be some type of awesome bond. But Raven, all I feel for her is contempt. And to know that she slept with your brother, how would you feel? I really don't know how to feel.
Well, what I can say is I told him that it was both dumb and inexcusable. But then again, it wouldn't be the first stupid thing that my brother's done in his life.
Then why?
Why what?
Why did you bring your brother into my life?
Phallon, I brought him into your life because I wanted you to be happy. After the damage that Clint had done, you needed to have some fun. You needed a refreshing start. And I mean, sure, I guess I turned out to be wrong. I've been wrong about a whole lot of things over the last year.
I don't know. What about him? What about him? You were working with him to put Victor in jail. If Victor's dead...
Victor is dead.
Well, he's going to show up and then start asking questions. Are you going to turn Vicky in?
No. I'm not a rat.
You're not a rat? Oh, because it's Vicky, your story changed. I don't believe you right now. The Jesus that I knew and that I fell in love with wanted nothing to do with his family. And as soon as Vicky shows up, everything changes.
Vicky has been my saving grace through all of this. She saved my life.
Saved your life, huh? Where was Vicky at when I was the only one that had your back? Vicky was nowhere to be found. It was just me.
You know, that's not what I meant.
Well, that's what it sounded like.
You know what? Fuck this. I can't believe you're fucking acting like this. I give you some good news and all you do is just fucking throw it back in my face. I'm out of here.
Winston, let's not talk about wrongs right now because we both have had our shares of wrongs in the past few years. Now, the real reason why I came back here is to let you know that I made a mistake.
Which mistake?
Isolating you out of my life. Winston, I was hurt. To find out about you and Ashton and you sneaking around with him, that broke my heart. Winston, you're the one that found him. You're the reason why I'm even at Easton in the first place. And ever since I got here, it's been nothing but a roller coaster ride.
Phallon, I don't want to talk about Ashton Banks.
Why? Did you guys break up?
I don't want to talk about it!
Okay. Okay. But what's wrong with you? Did something happen to you? It's like when I look in your eyes, I see emptiness. Almost like...
Like what, Phallon? Like what? Like I'm dead? Ever since things went bad between us, I felt a void inside of me that I thought I would never be able to fill. You know what? Ashton filled it. He loved me so passionately and deeply. I don't know what to do. I've unlocked things in myself that I've never thought I'd feel, a floodgate of emotions.
Okay. What happened? What's wrong?
I told you! Listen! I don't want to talk about this with you! Because you lost that right when you exiled me from your life.
Winston, I'm sorry. I am so sorry. And I know it's the last thing that you want to hear right now, but I need you to know that. I need you to understand that I am sorry. Just never forget that. Thank you.
Finally some peace and quiet.
Macen, open this door. I'm gonna eat some cookie and cream, ice cream and cookie dough, you Pillsbury doughboy. Open
it up! Are you fucking crazy? Just barging in here, you ain't running.
That was my aunt. I'm just coming to check up on you since you call out of work. Are you trying to avoid Brandon?
I'm not avoiding Brandon. I'm just trying to get through to him, but right now I just need my space. Can you just go?
I've been kicked out of better places, and by the looks of it, you haven't death. And I would gladly leave, but you have no friends right now. Look around. Who's here? But that means we must. You call a friend.
Kiko, you acted like a dust mop. Maybe I should use your weed to dust my table. God. You know, Brandon called me selfish. Do you think I'm selfish?
No, I don't think you're selfish. You help all of us in time of need. Especially when Ronnie was alive. So why would he call you selfish and why would I think you were selfish?
I don't know. The last person to call me selfish was Adonis.
You keep on bringing that name up. I mean, I only know about the breakup. So tell me more about Adonis. Was he good in bed? Did he have a big, fat dick? Was he a good kisser? How fine he is.
God, it's always Kiko.
I mean, damn, you keep on talking about Adonis, Adonis, Adonis. Tell me, I don't even know about the breakup.
Well, there was this one time that we were in the bedroom and... I'm surprised that you're up this early. Especially after the night that we had. I thought for sure you had to be in a coma for a couple of days. Babe. Are you ignoring me?
Nah, babe. Not at all. I just have some shit on my mind, that's all.
What could possibly have you up this early thinking this hard? I know it's not about the fight that we had the other day. We're good, babe. Besides, after that makeup sex all night long, I'm more than good.
Yeah. Last night was definitely dope. I mean, it just felt really good to be able to just talk and reconnect with you. I just got some shit going on right now, babe. Some stuff I need to work out.
Like what? I mean, you said that, well, we were going to work on our communication. Well, mainly you. And that you weren't going to hold back.
I did, but I don't know. It's just not about us. It's about me. Besides, I have a photo shoot in New York and I have to leave.
What? You just got home. You said you were going to be here for a while.
Look, I need the money. And besides, I'll be back within a couple of days. And we can pick right back up where we left off. Okay?
Stop looking at me like that.
What?
You know how you're looking at me. You're not going to make it to New York. And I'm not going to make it to the salon.
That's what that sound for, a quickie.
A quickie? What?
By the look of your face and that smile, it must have been good. Real juicy. Tell me more.
Well, then in perfect Adonis style, he gets a text message about him having to go to New York.
Hey, babe. I'm about to leave. Uber's going to be here in 3 minutes.
All right. I need to get up anyway before Ronnie starts blowing up my phone. I got to get to the salon. But I don't even know how I'm going to be able to stand. Oh, man. Thanks to you today.
I'm sure you'll manage.
Mm-hmm.
Babe.
Huh?
No, seriously. I just want you to know that I really do love you. I mean, I know I fucked up, but...
We both promised that we're not going to bring up the past no more. We're here, we got a fresh start. Nobody wants to talk about that.
Okay, well your ass also agreed that you're going to stop cutting me off.
You're right. Go ahead.
Seriously, no matter what, just want you to know that you are the love of my life. I want you to understand that.
Babe, I know, but what I need for you to do is hurry up and get back home.
Got you. I gotta go, okay?
All right.
Hey, babe. I love you.
So then what else happened?
That was it. Never heard from him again after that.
Seriously?
God, I remember your aunt, Ronnie, crazy ass. I was kind of just isolated and didn't want to talk to nobody, and oh, she hated Adonis. And this one time, she came over to my house. Adonis,
fuck her. Let me tell you what your problem is.
Now I have a problem?
Yes, you have a problem. You run around here putting all this energy into the wrong men. Yeah, Adonis looked good on the outside, but what good was it for your relationship?
Ronnie, I'm not trying to hear what you're saying right now.
And I ain't trying to buy the bullshit of you not hearing what I'm saying right now, but you're going to listen to it.
You didn't know Adonis like I knew him. He showed me a side of him that he didn't show everybody else.
And I'm sure it's a side that I would not care to see. If it had you looking like this, I'd be damned if it would have been me.
The whole situation just gave me a headache.
Should have given me one too. And it's this cheap ass wine you keep drinking. You run around here looking like the Grim Reaper. It ain't going to do nothing but make you look puffy and wore out. You're not going to walk around my shop like that.
You don't get it. I just knew for sure that he would just come walking back through the door and say he made a huge mistake.
Well, let's give it a minute. Maybe he will. Nope.
I don't understand it, Ronnie. Like,
listen, Macen, you need to get yourself together. You got some clients at the shop that's getting on my damn nerves. And if I didn't care, I wouldn't be here. But it's really pissing me off.
You think I'm selling myself short?
You've been so short. He ain't here, is he?
Look, I wasn't expecting you to swing past and just give me all this.
Yeah, right. Well, you ain't expecting a lot from me, but you're gonna get it.
Thanks, man.
You're welcome. Then expect a hug. I love you, Macen.
Oh, you too.
Mm. Get yourself together. You smell kind of bad, too. So, what's this?
Cheap ass
wine.
Oh, God. Leave it up to Ronnie. Always in somebody's damn business.
Yeah, that's my aunt.
God, I miss Ronnie.
I miss her, too.
Right now, if she was here, all this would never have happened.
Really?
No, it wouldn't. Ronnie kept everybody in line. Even though she couldn't even keep herself in line.
Yeah. She couldn't. Look at her.
You know, I wanted just to say thank you. For actually being understanding and staying here after everybody left.
I mean, you're welcome. I mean, we are friends. We do work together. And we learn to know each other's emotions and feelings and what they're going through. But next time, you can't hold this in.
You're right. But do me a favor.
What?
next time you come, don't wear that wig. Wow. Don't wear this all black. And that's stop wearing that fake Chanel bag.
That is the dress code, so what do you want me? I can just wear anything.
As a matter of fact, oh my god, everything's coming back to me. Get out.
Really?
Yeah, come on.
Really, you want to kick me out?
Get out, Kiko. Get out. I done got too emotional with you, then gave you too many dark secrets. All you're going to do is just throw it in my face.
No,
get out.
I'm not. I would never do that.
Kiko.
Can we go to the drink? Can you go wash up and get all this dirt, dog fur up off of you, then put some clothes on so we can get some drinks? Let's turn up.
I'll do it. Mopey. I'll do it. I'll do it. Under one condition.
What?
Get rid of that Mongolian wig.
See, don't try me.
It's not becoming. Get out. Come on. Out.
We're not getting no drinks?
No. Goodbye.
You just want to be mopey. You know,
oh, goodbye. Yes.
Eating your bonbons.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Oh, see? There's your dog right there. Can't even help nobody.
Why did I tell that girl anything?
I know you hate me right now, but we really need to talk. Can I come in?
Why should I let you in my house?
Jabril. Because I want to apologize. I owe you that much. So please let me come in.
Fine. Come in.
Thank you.
Let me hear you. Try to bullshit your way out of this. I really can't stomach you too much right now, so just get to it so you can get going.
I'm just as much of a victim in this as you are. Eve told me she was pregnant, but I didn't know whether or not the baby was yours. Shit, she conned me too.
Conned? The lies just keep coming.
Jabril, I'm not lying to you. You know that tramp sleeps around with everybody. I didn't want any of her bullshit being associated with Davenport's name. So yes, I paid her to leave.
See, that doesn't make sense. You're smarter than that. So you paid her without even getting a DNA test?
No, I asked her to get a DNA test. She refused. So before she can go run and sell the story to any type of reporter, I pay her to go.
Okay.
Jabril, I'm not lying to you. I'm not lying. Listen, I was confused. I didn't know what else to do. I even had Rob help me out.
Rob?
Yes, Rob.
Of all people.
Listen, I wasn't thinking about the problems that you and Rob have. I know that I needed help. So then, I needed somebody to help me. He was the only one that was there. I mean, he even helped me get the results back for Raven's DNA.
And how'd that plan out? How'd that work?
Let's just say, biologically, she's your niece.
Well, look at there. Look at the irony. You got exactly what you wanted. Your child got dropped right on your lap.
My child got dropped right on my lap. This is not what I wanted. Not like this.
You asked for it.
I might as well have been a surrogate. I don't know her. She doesn't know me. There's no connection. I can't even see a positive relationship coming up out of this.
But here's the thing. That's your child, so you need to make it work or try to figure it out.
I'm not even concerned about that at this point. I want to help you find JJ.
Do you hear yourself?
Yes, I hear myself.
My possible child, but you know you have one.
Uh, listen, a lot has happened. A lot has happened. And I really don't know how to feel about the entire situation right now. All I know is I actually have somewhat of a relationship with JJ, but I make a deal with you. If you allow me to help you find him, I'll think about trying to have some sort of relationship with Raven. Some sort. Can't make you any promises, though.
Okay.
Is really that cut and dry okay?
Take it or leave it.
I'll take it. Well, I will give you a hug and a kiss, but I know that's not going to happen right now. So, can I call you tomorrow so we can get started on this search?
You do that.
What do you want?
Listen, bitch. If you want to see nothing happen to your little robotic fag, you might want to bring that ass. Fag. You know who the fuck I'm talking about, Winston. If you don't want nothing to happen to him, Phallon, you might want to come get to this waterfall. You heard me. I'm done.
You better not hurt him, Clint. Clint, what are you up to?
Done, Phallon.
What are you up to?
The waterfall. Get here.
Okay.
What are you looking at?
What?
You look. It's January, right? Now it's a beautiful day. Don't get me wrong, it's beautiful. A little Indian summer day. But, you know,
what?
You couldn't wait to bring that out the closet, huh?
We're having a nice day, and we're not gonna have a nice day like this again for a very long time. So, why not take advantage of today? Look at the sun, it's shining.
I like the way you think. Like the way you think, you're absolutely right. It's beautiful. So much is beautiful. I know I get mushy every now and then.
What are you trying to butter me up for? What do you want?
I wanted to know what you have planned this weekend. Actually,
work.
Work. Wait, I didn't know you were working for me.
I work every other weekend.
Oh right, last weekend. So that means that we're going to have to make some rearrangements. I'm going to need you to take off work.
Take off for work for what? Okay, I'm not going to ask you more questions.
Take off for work. I'm taking you out, damn it. I'm going to show you a great night.
Oh, so you're trying to make the most of this weekend?
I'm always trying to make the most.
So that means we're going to do everything.
Take you out, wine you, dine you, try some new foods, maybe take a little walk in the park, see where it's going, and then at the end of it, take it home.
Damn. What is that, like
that was, yeah, that was like my, you ain't like it.
With the push part, what are you pushing?
Nah, seriously.
I would call this climatic. Wouldn't you, Winston? I mean, the thought that both of us would come to a place that I'm sure Ashton introduced us both to. How is Ashton? I mean, I haven't seen him in a while. Well, I haven't seen him since that night. That night you guys had that little romantic dinner at the fucking Indigo. Yeah. So, how was Ashton? Winston, just to let you know, oh my God, that night was fucking amazing. Ooh, it was freezing outside, but my fucking blood was on fire, Winston. Oh my God. It was like a light, a fucking beacon. I mean, the energy in my body just guided me to unexpected destinations that night, Winston, and I learned some things about you. Why are you so quiet, Winston? I mean, I heard you were so good at expressing yourself. I did. I heard that you like to give pleasure and fucking pain. Oh, Winston. How was it that you were able to hide your sadistic urges from your master, Phallon? Huh? I get it though. I mean, Phallon treats everybody like a slave. I was lucky though. I was the fucking field nigga. So I got a chance to go out and roam and get away from Massa. But you had to be there to be the typical house nigga and do everything and everything she told you, reporting and all. How is Ashton? What's wrong, Winston? Did I strike a nerve? Is that it? Are you and Ashton even still together? Oh, is he mad at you from all that shit I told him that night? See, I had to let out little slut possum know just how much the man that he tried to substitute me for was worse than me. I gotta admit it though. He was mad at first, he was hurt, but I'm gonna say it took all of about 5 minutes. I mean, he just wiped that shit right out of him. I'm normally a little more private. And I don't like to kiss and tell, but I want you to know. That night, I fucked the dog shit out of Ashton. I fucked him so hard he came and he didn't even touch his motherfucking son. Oh, what's wrong? That Ashton, oh my God. He's got some good pussy though, right? Right? So again, man, how is Ashton Winston?
Why, Clint? Why did you do it? You wanted payback from me that bad? You wanted payback from Phallon? Even Derek. That would make sense. But Ashton? What the fuck did Ashton ever do to you?
You fucking took everything from me. You! My fucking wife loved me, and then you got her motherfucking ear. You drugged me. You fucking sexually violated me. You publicly humiliated me.
And then you thought I was gonna let you fucking get away with that. You, much like my motherfucking wife, have got me fucked up, Winston.
Clint, let me explain something to you. You have gotten yourself fucked up. You know, that's my fucking problem. People like you who can't take responsibility, you can't take blame for your own shit. Clint, you are the worst type of person that exists on the face of this earth. Nothing about you deserves any vindication. And that is why, Clint, the only thing you deserve, the only fate that's coming to you, is death. And on that note, I'm going to be the gentleman who delivers it to you, Clint. Now, when I thought about us meeting each other finally, I thought I'd have to plan it carefully, strategically. But I now see, I now know that this was destiny. Clint, God has brought me here today. He wants me. I truly believe, I think that my whole life has been about this very moment, to rid the earth of the scum, the most pure evil, to walk the face of it. Every person you've come across, you scarred. Every life you have been pure evil and caused pain and toxicity. You have infected every person who has believed in you with your shit. And of all the people, you hurt Ashton the most with your deceit.
Jabril, I've been calling your name. Are you okay?
Just lost in my head.
Okay, you said in the dark.
I want you to know that I really love you, and I don't want anything else to come between us. I put everything on the table, and you know, I'm out of deceit. I just want us to be happy. So, you believe me?
Yes, I do, Jabril. I want us to be happy too. No more secrets. I'm done with those. Why that smile?
Nothing. I just missed you today.
Missed you too, babe. I've been calling your phone, but it's been going to voicemail.
I was busy with meetings all day, I'm sorry. But found out some interesting developments.
Is that a good or a bad thing?
Depends. Good for some, crippling for others, but either way, I'll be fine.
Well, as long as it doesn't stress you out.
You know, I thought I was gonna let it get to me, but
I realize you just, things just aren't promised, you know? I guess all's fair in love and war.
Love and war? Huh?
Oh. I think I got that mixed up. I'm in business. Business and war. Yeah, I don't know where that love part came from.
Okay.
So, your day. How'd that go?
It was cool. Ran a few errands with Kiko for the salon.
Oh, well, glad I didn't pop over. I was going to surprise you at lunch, but meetings had me tied up.
That would have been a very sweet thought.
Yeah. Had some other stuff planned too, but when I found out what I found out at work.
The purest, the most loving person that I have ever met. You killed. You took him from me. You killed him.
Killed Winston. All these fucking riddles and God talk. What the fuck are you talking about, Winston? Is Ashton okay?
Stop fucking playing with me! Use these last few moments of your pathetic fucking life to cleanse yourself.
Winston, this whole year, since you and Phallon had me at that motherfucking house, I've already lived every day like it was my last. I have no regrets, Winston. I have zero fucks to give. And I am sorry for nothing. But maybe you should be. Maybe you should absolve yourself, Winston. Where is Ashton? What did you do? Tell me, Winston.
You knew! You fucking knew! The only way that you could get me is to catch me while my guard is down. So you drugged me. And you drugged Ashton, and you fucking killed him.
Killed him, Winston? Why would I kill Ashton? Winston, 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 what did you do?
Shut up! Yo, cut the lies, cut the bullshit. Do you have any last words?
Sucks a nightclub.
What? What are you saying?
That's what I inject in you. In Ashton sucks in Michael. But I used a synthetic form. I wanted you to know what it felt like. To be helpless, Winston. What it felt like to think that something probably fucking happened to you and you not never ever know what it was. I wanted to do to you what you did to me.
What you saying, huh? What you saying, Clint?
Couldn't bring myself to do it, so.
With things with that, cuz I know some things I could think of.
But... Oh. Hold on, I got some other updates for you.
Updates? What updates? Did you find out about Eve, my son?
No, not quite, but I agreed to let Tessa help me try to work some magic, rare connections. It's a good chance that Victor has him enrolled in school somewhere, so she's going to make a few calls, see if she can get a hold of some rosters.
That's awesome news, babe. I know you're anxious to find out. It still fucks with me that Phallon held that information from you, and Macen knew too. He tried to give me every excuse in the book, but I was not falling for that bullshit.
Yeah, Phallon actually came by here not too long ago trying to explain and apologize again.
I hope you kicked her ass out.
I actually did the first time, but this sounds a little different. I actually listened to her song, I guess, and She was like in a weird place.
A weird place? What's that mean?
Well, apparently, Raven is actually her daughter.
You have to be fucking kidding me. Karma is a bitch. Here she is holding a child from you, and she has a child she can't even connect with, all because she's evil. Why do you need enemies when you got a family like yours?
My thoughts exactly. Speaking of enemies, have you talked to Rob lately?
No, why you ask me that?
Really? Wow. Some friends you have.
Excuse me, what is that supposed to mean?
Well, Phallon let me know that she told Rob a few months back about Eve's son. And she let him know that JJ was mine.
He knew what?
I guess him and Macen are in the same boat.
I cannot believe
it. But you know what I just can't understand is how she could tell someone that pretty much despises me. And I pretty much have the same mutual feeling towards. But I guess, I mean, I can't expect honesty and loyalty from people. Bird, huh?
I guess when it comes to Phallon, you can't.
Phallon. Yeah. That's the only person I should worry about.
I just got hungry, babe. I'm gonna go make me a sandwich and take a shower. Want me to make you one too?
Nah, I'm good. You being here is enough for me.
Sure, okay, I'm about to go. Don't fall asleep before I come to shower.
I'll be waiting right here for you.
Alright then.
I gave you and Ashton the same dose of the same thing. I wanted you to know what it felt like to be helpless. What it felt like to think that somebody could have did something to you and you never knew what it was. I wanted you to think that I did to you what you did to me, Winston. But I would never, ever touch you, Winston. You disgust me. What happened to Ashton Winston? I laid y'all in a bed together. And I wanted y'all to wake up.
He was dead! I felt his heartbeat! He hadn't had one!
Dead, Winston. It slows down your heart rate. It paralyzes you. It paralyzes your fucking nervous system. But you fucking wake up. Look at you, Winston.
Shut up!
Tell me!
Shut up! You knew! You knew!
You're right here. What happened to Ashton? Winston, what did you do? Winston!
Oh my God, Winston! Winston, put the gun down.
Winston, put the gun down. I thought it best that she hear from your mouth some of the shit you've done.
Clint, shut up! Shut the fuck up!
Phallon, as much as you deserve to relish in this moment right now with me, I need you to leave. Immediately.
Winston, he is not worth it. No.
No! No! You of all people know that he deserves this! What he is, an abomination to all of us!
I know.
He's caused all of us so much pain!
Winston, I know. I know. And after what I just heard on the telephone, I never thought that he could hurt someone worse than he hurt me. But he hurt you far, far worse. And for that, I am so sorry.
What the fuck are you sorry for, Phallon? Ask him where Ashton is. He did something. He is trying to pin it on me. Don't say his name again! Don't!
Winston, he ain't worth it. He ain't worth it. You're gonna have to kill me.
Move, Phallon! Move!
No. Winston. I can't do that. I was selfish. I was selfish. I was hurt. And I let it consume me. And I just tried to control you because my life was spiraling out of control. I love Clint. Like you love Ashton. And I'm sorry.
He never deserved your love. Ever. Phallon, you have no idea what I did. No idea.
No. But we've all done some awful things. All of us. But when will the cycle end? When will it end? I loved you. And you hurt me. You knew everything that I've been through with men. And you were the one that was supposed to change everything and fix all of that. But instead, you hurt me worse.
I did.
No, Clint, no. All of us here have been fucked up so long internally that we don't even know how to love properly, none of us. It ain't worth it. Ashton wouldn't want you to do this. This is not how the story should end.
You don't know what I did!
Doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is what you're not doing right now. This could have went so many different ways.
So what the fuck, you want me to say thank you, Phallon? Please. I could have got that gun out of his little frail ass hands whenever I wanted, and you know it.
Could you?
See, that's the problem with Phallon. Mm-hmm. You've always underestimated me, and you still do.
No, dear husband. I do know that you are the most slimiest, grimiest piece of shit that I've ever had the misfortune to come in contact with.
There she is. The wife that I know and knew. I knew you didn't mean all that psychological bullshit that you was feeding your fucking pet.
No, dear husband. I meant every word of it.
Phallon,
You see, you have underestimated me all of this time. Stop moving. It would be too easy for me to pull this trigger and finish what somebody started last year. Too easy. But you see, one day soon, legally, I'm going to be free from your ass. And I'm going to find me somebody that loves me and appreciates me and appreciate having a good woman by their side. And I'm going to take pleasure in knowing that your ass is still walking around here miserable. So don't you ever fucking underestimate me, okay?
Fuck you,
Phallon. Yeah, fuck me.
No one's ever gonna fucking love you. Divorce is a gift, Phallon. And you will never fucking get rid of me. Ever. You'll see. You'll fucking see.
Thank you.